It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. Two things that Northerners may no longer enjoy if power shifts back to the South. The news in full. There are two different things that the people in the northern part of the country will not be enjoying again if the power goes back to the southern part of the country. All governors in the southern part of the country have already agreed to produce the next president of the country and the upcoming presidential election. The Southerners are serious about it, and there are some actions towards it already. The first indication is that the opposition party has recently zoned its chairmanship position to the northern part of the country. If the national chairman of the party comes from the north, the south will likely produce the presidential candidate of the party. It is now becoming clear that the flag bearer of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, will come from the southern part of the country. On the ruling party side, the members of the party have been projecting Mr. Ashiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu to be the flag bearer of All Progressive Congress APC. If things are going on like this, the Southeasterners will produce the next president of the country. President Muhammadu Buhari, who is a northerner, has been the one ruling for the past 6 years, and there are tendencies some things will change if the power goes back to the south in the year 2023 presidential election. There are things that the northerners have been enjoying now that they may no longer be available in the year 2023. 1. Open grazing. Some northerners that are elders believe in taking their cattle to different places to feed them. They also believe their cattle that they are moving from place to place will grow rapidly than the ones that are reared at a spot. While this is well with the northerners, some southerners have kicked against the open grazing system because some of the elder herdsmen are unknowingly trampling on their farmlands. Some southern governors have suggested cattle ranching for the northerners, but it is not effective on the northerners' end. If the power goes back to the southern part of the country, southern leaders may ban open grazing, and this will affect the northerners a lot. Regional politics. Now that the power is still in the northern part of the country, most of the people under the cabinet of President Muhammadu Buhari are from the northern part of the country. Although some people think that the presidency is free to choose his ministers from any region he likes, but most of the posts and positions have been going to the northern part of the country, and if power shifts back to the northern part of the country, northerners may not enjoy the benefits again. And these are the reasons are cited by Lunacy that the northerners may no longer enjoy if power actually shifts back to the south. However, we remember that the south,
if at a particular time the southerners feel they need the support of the north to install their own in the highest office of the land, then this should come with a lobby and appeal, not intimidation and harassment. A simple arithmetic that out of the 24 years of Nigeria's democracy, southern Nigeria ruled the country for a cumulative of 13 years 3 months, while the northern Nigeria ruled for 10 years, 9 months. If I may ask, honestly and sincerely, between the region that ruled for 13 years and 3 months and the one that has 10 years, 9 months, which deserves to produce the next president? We have found ourselves in a society that has so much distortions about the truth, is interested in conspiracy theories and spreading propaganda, but to put the record straight, Northern Nigeria has found itself in a very pathetic situation that is always marginalized even when one of its own is leading the country because of the overdomination of southerners in the critical spheres of governance. This led to the underdevelopment of the region. Few examples can surface. The number of companies that collapsed in Kano State alone between 1999 and 2007 were in hundreds, mostly due to poor electricity supply. At the time, companies in Lagos and other southern states continue to flourish. In Niger State alone, Nigeria generates a very high percentage of power and Kanji Power Station, Jeba Power Station, Shiruro Power Station, Presently, the Sungeru hydropower project is ongoing in the same Niger state, which is expected to generate 700 milliwatts. But take a visit to Minna, the Niger state capital, and see how the epileptic power supply is in that country. In that state, there exists threat of further underdevelopment of the northern Nigeria if a southerner is imposed on the nation, as the agitators demand. The northern Nigeria is at liberty to retain power from now to God, when God knows her destinies. It is because that is all that remains for the region to hold on to, as the civil service and the economic business is dominated by southerners. The north should go back to drawing board and put all hands on deck to bring out an experienced, qualified cosmopolitan, the person of integrity and God-fearing individual that believes in the unity and development of Nigeria, who will uphold the right of the minority to contest for the upcoming 2023 presidential election and use its voting power to bring him into office for peace and progress of our dear nation. Lawan wrote from Ausawa, Asibiti Ward, Potiskum, Yobe State, and it's quite something to check if what Lawan has actually written was effective about the southern governor's agitation. He is of the opinion that, looking at the calculation very well, that the southern part of the of Nigeria had ruled for 13 years and some months, while the northern Nigeria has ruled for 10 years and some months, saying that if we are to check it, then the northern governor, the northern part of the country, the northern region, ought to be the next one to produce the president, because they are just blackmailing that there should be a rotation and the likes like that, saying that that is how it has been, but not checking in-depthly how this may go, and that if at all there has to be such rotation to the south, then it should not be as a result of intimidation, harassment, or otherwise. It should be appealed for, and it should be negotiated or lobbied with the north, and not insisting as if it was constitutionally guided or their rights, saying that the southerners dominate important parts of the country and the administration, and therefore the north should also maintain the seat of the president for as long as destiny implies, seeing that what the north just needs to do now is go back to the drawing board and bring out somebody that is experienced and qualified for the 2023 presidential election. Thanks for listening. And that is the news. Thanks for listening.